a small presentation which gives an overview of Toastmasters. This is primarily for the benefit of those who are new to Toastmasters. There are some who will be sworn in today, who have attended a few meetings. There are some of the members who are quite new and they might like a brush up on some of the aspects of Toastmasters. You can ask me any questions that you have at the end of the session. The reason we thought that it's, somewhere down the line we need to present this to the audience is because we go through this routine of the meetings, and we go through the routine of people taking up roles, people giving their speeches, and also sometimes helping in organizing an event within the club. But there might be an occasion where you have a query which can be addressed on a one-to-one, but here is a structured way of addressing some of these queries. So what is Toastmasters? I've divided this into two parts. The first is I'll give you an overview of Toastmasters, and the second is we'll get into what is the value that it brings. As Toastmaster Vijayanand mentioned, 270,000 members, more than 270,000 members, over 13,000 clubs in 116 countries across the world. It was established by the visionary Ralph C. Smedley in 1924. How does Toastmasters work? Toastmasters isn't something where there is someone who gives a speech and you learn and you have an interactive session. No, it is more of a learn by doing workshop. And what learn by doing workshop means, you cannot imbibe unless you take part in it. For instance, for people who just joined the club, they take up roles. So they take up the role of, before they even giving their first speech, they take up a role of the grammarian, the accountant, the time manager. And this helps. This is sometimes it's the beginning of the journey in the learning. So it's a learn by doing workshop. When do you practice? You get to practice during the weekly meetings, wherein the members roles give prepared or impromptu speeches. So filling meeting roles. Every meeting is about honing communication skills. But there are people who run the show. So for the people who run the show are not people who are coming from, who are not employees of Toastmasters International. But they are all voluntarily, all the roles are voluntarily taken up by the members. For example, the Master of Ceremonies, the Table Topic Master, everybody, or even the leadership roles within the committee is also taken up voluntarily by the members. So there is a term of 6 months wherein you have a team of 7 people who lead the club, which includes the president, vice president, education, membership, PR, secretary, treasurer, and sergeant at arms. So these rotate every 6 months. Similarly, moving to how there is no instructor. As I mentioned, there is no one who is going to come and give a lecture, deliver a lecture. Now, how does the Toastmasters journey? What is exactly the Toastmasters journey? Toastmasters journey comprises of two tracks. A lot of us come to Toastmasters in order to improve our communication skills. That is what I've heard over the past 3 years being a member. Everyone saying that I wanted to improve my communication skills. And the beauty of Toastmasters is that there are two tracks. There is not only the communication track, but there is also the leadership track. Which the communication track is... So what is the leadership track all about? Anyone amongst the new members or... Yes?
All the roles that we wanted to take up.
Yes.
So we need to finish some of those and proceed through these various levels.
Absolutely. So the leadership track is you are absolutely right. And how does taking up the roles become help you become a better leader?
Well, each of these members are speaking in every meeting, obviously. So it helps you speak, it helps you guide the meeting like you would in a
Okay. Anybody else? How does taking up these roles help you become a better leader?
It's because you are.
Can I borrow a leadership manual from anyone? A CL manual. Now what it says is that leadership consists of, or Toastmasters has defined certain skills as essential leadership skills, which is listening, critical thinking, giving feedback, time management, planning and implementation, organization and delegation, facilitation, motivation, mentoring. So, do you agree that all these are leadership skills?
Yes.
And it's a very, very scientifically designed program, wherein if you take up, say, a role of a time manager, what you are doing is you are honing your listening skills. Not only that, you are also honing your facilitation skills. So, when you take up the time manager role, say, 4 times, then that gets recorded in your CL manual. And similarly, when you take up the role of master of ceremonies, you become a better facilitator. And you are, at that time, once you've taken up the role of master of ceremonies, you get that entry in the facilitation. So that is how you grow in the leadership track. And giving feedback is also a leadership quality. It's an art. A feedback given properly can build somebody, a feedback given improperly can, you know, crush somebody's aspirations. So that is the art of giving feedback is through evaluations. That is again a leadership skill. This is all at the level of the competent leader. But, okay, now coming to competent communicator. So in a competent communicator, what do you do? It's more simple over there. All you need to do is go through the 10 speeches which have the various objectives, like the first speech is just an icebreaker. The second speech which Inder gave today is how to organize your speech. And then you have other projects which involve gestures, which involve voice modulation. And then you have the project 10, which is to inspire, right? You move on to the advanced leadership role, wherein it requires you to take up roles at slightly larger scale. You know, you have to give education sessions, you have to work on, you know, work as a team in organizing an event, maybe within the club. You have to undergo training and, you know, going forward, taking up a leadership position within a club also helps you grow as a leader in the leadership track. And similarly, there are advanced communication speeches which get categorized into storytelling. Now, once you have done your 10 speeches, you can get into a story, you can go for a storytelling manual, or you can go for entertaining speech, you can go for humorous speech, you can go for speaking to inform. So similarly, you can then, you know, if you are a trainer, you can decide on what speech you want, what manual you want to select as far as the advanced manual is concerned. Once you've finished your basic communicator, you can decide whether you want to go in for professional speaking, speaking to inform. So that is how. The ultimate goal is to become a, what is this? A distinguished postmaster. That's the ultimate aim, which can be repeated. But to begin with, the aim is to become a distinguished postmaster. And within the club, we have got ours being a club with such a rich heritage, we've got people at all levels. We've got a gentleman who is very soon aspiring to become a distinguished Toastmaster, Mr. Vijayanand himself. And we've got people who are just, on level 1, just giving their icebreaker, and of course their aspirations will be as great. Yeah. So I have mentioned about the advanced communication series. So leadership track I have mentioned to you. So advanced leadership program basically entails developing a vision. So this goes beyond the club, it goes beyond the area. There are 5 clubs which make up one area in Toastmasters. There are around 8 areas which make up a division. So your vision can extend beyond being a part of the club. You can, you know, aspire to lead the division. Or there are, I think, 14 divisions which form a district. So you can even aspire to go. So the sky is the limit as far as growth in Toastmasters is concerned. And you grow along with that. So this is something that we have experienced. Practical presentation experience. It's a different thing to take a set of slides and run through it. But to actually communicate with an audience is something that Toastmasters teaches you. A safe place to make mistakes and learn, mentorship opportunities. This is a very important point. Every new member or a new member to the club is assigned a member, is assigned a
mentor.
So the mentor is the person whom he is basically like a sounding board. Every speech that the member makes, he goes to the mentor, sounds it off, rehearses with the mentor, and then he presents it. So the mentor is basically someone who has his own style of grooming the aspirant Toastmasters. I'll run through these. I am actually out of time right now, but there are any questions you can ask me. It is not up to the mentor or the president club officers who decides as to, you know, how quickly you are going to become a CC, a CL, going forward an ACB, an ACES. An ALB, who's going to decide that? So it's a self-paced program, right? The more you put into, as one of our senior and experienced Toastmasters says, the more you put into Toastmasters, the more you get. It's as simple as that. So here we have weekly meetings, we meet every week. There are peer evaluations, participation in leadership through meeting roles, personal attention and small group setting. Now coming to the dues. I have discussed the benefits of Toastmasters and even the leadership skills that you develop. Right? The same are highlighted over here. Critical thinking skills, listening skills, time management skills. What the value that it brings is unlimited personal growth, clear communication skills, self-confidence, positive mentoring relations. Now here is a quote, the founder of Mrs. Fields Cookies, she says, the idea of getting in front of a group not as Mrs. Fields. If you Google Mrs. Fields, you will see these cookies. It has become synonymous with this name, with the name of this person, because it's named Mrs. Fields Cookies. But as Debbie, made my knees shake. So Mrs. Fields, her name is Debbie. But as Mrs. Fields, everybody knows her, but as Debbie, our knees shook. Toastmasters group understood. Here's a place where you can learn, grow, develop, and where other people are doing and feeling the same thing. I think as product manager Ratan Shetty, everybody knew me. But as Ratan Shetty, Toastmasters helped me kind of unravel that aspect of speaking about the individual. So anybody's heard of Tom Peters, the management guru? Tom Peters, Leonard Nimoy, Mr. Spock from Star Trek. Some of these familiar names, they are all Toastmasters. Again a quote from the former governor of Hawaii, who says that Toastmasters is the best and least expensive personal improvement class you can go to. So these are the dues which the club pays to Toastmasters International, new member fees and the 6 months membership dues. And what the new member needs to pay to the club, our treasurer would have briefed you. And you can get in touch with any of the committee members to know the details on that. So why is Toastmasters for you? A low cost communication leadership training. Practical experience, confidence building, networking, constructive evaluations. This is a website, it's a beautiful website. It is such an exhaustive website that you can just get lost in the amount of information that is available. Do visit the website and get more information.